What is up, guys? Tomcat here, and today we are back in Spin Tires, and we're going to be looking at one absolutely massive vehicle and one absolutely tiny vehicle. It's actually not really a vehicle in a way it isn't a vehicle. I mean, like, well, you could put, oh, wow. So, Chauffanche, that's about the only thing you could put on it. Wait a second. Okay, there we go. Oh my god, listen to that! It's got all-wheel drive! Holy! Oh no, it actually works! It sounds perfect, too. Like, it sounds actually how you would imagine it. Whoa, it handles funny. Oh, it handles so weird. I don't know how I feel about this so far, because so far it doesn't handle how I would expect it to. And let me go into the... Oh my god, it's like the proper view too for first person. Uh-oh, it's getting stuck though. Oh, nope. Holy crap. The resilient little, like, what? Garden tiller. Yeah, the resilient garden tiller lives on. I didn't even notice those blades were spinning until I just now looked a second ago. That's really cool. Like, that's actually really, really cool. I love how you could see the belt belts turning too. Well, actually, I take that back. You can see the pulleys turning, not the belts. The belts don't actually turn at all. Jeez, I will say, it's, whoa, that's getting a bit unsettled, like, a lot unsettled, actually. Will you go in the direction I point you, I keep forgetting that this is rear steer only, and if the rear is bouncing up and down, which it is most of the time, you're not gonna actually turn. So that makes it really difficult when you're going over rough terrain, because it just never wants to turn. It never does. It never wants to turn. And so you get into this weird bouncing motion. Don't fall off, please. Cause I guarantee you that this thing has like a toleration for, as far as like actually falling off that edge, there's no actual suspension. It's literally just axles connected to wheels. So you're not gonna have any flex before the thing dies. So, and also keeping it on this bridge is of utmost importance. Turn back left, 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 left. Oh, now you go left. All right, now you go. Jeez, this is horrible to drive. I mean, I suppose it'd be okay in your yard, but here, no! Oh my god! Jeez! His spine would be dust at this point. Literally hit, oh jeez. This is not going well. This is not going well at all. Oh my god! I mean, hey, and the thing is, even if you try to point it in a straight line, it doesn't really work properly, because whenever the back wheel bounces off of something, it changes direction. So it never, even when you're just going straight, when you're not really steering it that much, it doesn't go in a straight line. So it's, yeah, well, his arms are now broken completely, utterly, and totally, thanks to a demonic garden tiller. If you could just go back the other direction, that would be, I want to drive the big truck now. I've never driven this truck. So, this version is supposed to have extra boost. So holy crap, that is a massive, massive bull bar and cage setup. Let's see a couple of different wheel and tire options. What about this one? Those are badass. Those are like almost like giant dump truck wheels. What about these? Those are weird. I like the middle ones. I like the middle ones a lot. They have a really good tire, and they have a, like, the wheel actually looks really nice too. Garage tent. That's a really big one too. Let's see. That's, I guess, for, like, just logs, tree trunks, stuff like that. Cart, trailer, Scania. I don't think that's directed, like, for this. What else do we have here? A couple different things we have. Oh, okay. We could do... I mean, if we wanted to do something crazy long, like, we could. But that's, like... Okay, that's, like, extra fuel tanks. That's another one of your... Oh, okay. So we can do, like, basically the normal setup if you wanted to do it. A wagon. You can tow your wagon behind it. Oh, it's got those, like, one of those massive, like, those crazy huge trailers, too. I'm gonna just put a garage tent on the back, just because it's basic, and I want to actually have something on the back of the truck. I don't want it to just be, a bare frame. So, without any further ado, let's start this thing up and set off, and... See, oh god, diff lock always, and I'm guessing all-wheel drive always as well. So really, you're never out of all-wheel drive, and your diffs are always locked. So that's a recipe for going everywhere. Oh wow, it's fast. It's fast for a big truck like this. Like, for a big truck like this, it's very fast. I do like the fact that both of the front axles have steering as well. This is so much easier to drive than the garden tiller. Imagine that. Let's see if it'll knock trees over. Oh, God, yeah. Okay. This thing does not give a crap. It will barrel through everything. Well, maybe not the big trees, but still. Most of these trees, it'll barrel straight through them. And I feel like this thing would be amazing for climbing up hills, too. Let's see if it can take this tree. Oh, dude, no! Was a little too solid for it. Oh, it's gonna get... Really? It's gonna get stuck there. Alright, we're gonna take it back to the garage. We're gonna turn right instead of left. Well, actually, we're gonna turn left instead of right, because it respawned us in the opposite direction of what we normally are in. So, no big deal. We can just turn it around. Oh, I could take it around the circuit that I used to take trucks, but the thing is, that circuit is for, like, really small vehicles, and this would not fit. Like, I'm gonna just straight up say it. This would not fit. It's not, like, a question of would it fit. It just wouldn't fit. Which I feel like that would be partially the entertaining part, but I don't know. God, this thing eats mud. Like, oh my god, this thing goes through it like it's nothing. Even in automatic mode, like, I'm gonna run it, like, up the river and see what happens. This thing is, like, properly badass and huge. Wonder what high range in the gearbox is like. Let's let it shift up in the third. Is it gonna go for fourth? Yep. High range is, oh, okay, oh my god, high range is really quick. Dude, this thing just freaking goes. It absolutely just freaking goes. Like, we're just charging up the river right now. No other, like, big truck that I've driven in recent memory can do this. No big truck that I've driven in recent memory, especially an 8x8 with like, dual axle steering. Like, normally these trucks are really good for hauling, but they're very, very slow, and they don't really do well in the mud or in the rivers. This is the complete opposite of that. This thing is a machine. Oh, I want to take this hill, or I'll see if it can take this hill. Dude! Holy crap! This thing is a monster! Oh, it's having trouble. If I can keep the wheel speed going. Ah, dang it. Alright, I was gonna say, if I can keep the wheel speed going, we would have been able to take that. Alright, second, we can get it into high. And you know what? I'm gonna go straight. Well, straight around to the left of this pine tree. Oh god. Got a little bit of a spinning issue, but it's all good. Should be able to power it up the hill. Come on. No! No! Oh, that's all it's gonna do. Damn, that's all it's gonna do, guys. Wow. I'll tell you what, though, for as big as it is, it was able to do a hell of a lot with what it's like, with the weight that it's working with. Like, the size and weight that this thing is working with, it's able to go a hell of a lot of places and go there really, really, really quickly. So, I love this truck. I would not mind using it again for, like, objective-based gameplay. Like, and I don't normally do, like, you know, lumber hauling and stuff like that. I do more, like, trail riding and exploring and things like that. But, like, dude, even for exploring, if you want something that is just massive, bigger than any other truck that you're going to run into that's anywhere close to this fast, this is the truck to get. I mean, holy crap. I think it's a little bit older, but it's got to be somewhere on the Steam Workshop if you look for it. So, yeah, this thing is a masterpiece. I absolutely love it, and I would recommend it to anybody and everybody that wants to have basically the most badass 8x8 in the game. At least the most badass 8x8 in the game so far in terms of, like, you know, mudding ability, like, river fording ability, speed, power. This thing has it all. So, again, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave me a like for these two crazy mods. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe for more. Let me know in the comments below what y'all thought of it, and I'll see you guys next time. Talk to y'all later.